Howdy, I'm Pop Haydn. I wanted to tell you a little story about a fascinating period of American history, the gold rush in Alaska back in the 1890s. Now, everybody coming up to the Yukon to search for gold had to pass through a little town called Skagway, Alaska. What the problem with that was that that town was run by one of the most notorious con men of the 19th century, Jefferson Randolph Soapy, they called him, Smith. Soapy Smith had a gang of 100 con men, and he had every kind of way of taking people's money. He was an expert at gambling, at the three-shell game, at three-card money, and fast and loose, faro, poker, whatever you had. He had 100 men who were all expert swindlers and con men and knew how to take people's money with every kind of device and means. It was a very, very terrible time for people to get through that town of Skagway without losing their shirts. And once they got to the gold field and made themselves rich, the very few that did, mining the gold, they had to come back down through Skagway and pass through town again, where they were always at the mercy of these con men. Wilson Misner was one of Soapy's men. He later became a famous aphorist and playwright and was one of the founders of the Brown Derby restaurant in Los Angeles. He had done for Soapy, he'd worked for Soapy as an assayist. He would weigh the gold using these little brass weights. Now, one of the tricks he would do is put a carpet under his table so that every time somebody, he was weighing the gold, for somebody, he'd drop a little bit of gold dust here, pinch there onto the carpet. He would just knock it off or brush it off somehow. He'd always manage to lose a little bit, actually quite a bit over time. And after a couple of weeks, he had burned that carpet. What was left was the gold, which he shared with Soapy and the gang. But these guys were very clever with their hands, and they used to practice their slide. There was a lot of downtime. So a guy like Wilson Misner, when he wasn't weighing the gold, he was just sitting there waiting for a customer, he would have these little weights that they used on the scales to measure with. In fact, you can examine these if you would like. You can look at them, check them out. They're just little brass weights, and they're kind of heavy. What they would do while they were killing time was just play with these weights and practice their sleight of hand, which became truly phenomenal after hours and hours of this practice. They were able to shoot these things from hand to hand so skillfully you couldn't even see it. It would look something like this. They'd cover two. Now, you could cover any two of these at the same time, and then they would just go chink-a-chink, 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 and that was the trick. I'll do it again. I know that was a little fast. I'll do it again. Watch this close now. We'll cover these two. We'll go boom, like that. Chink-a-chink. 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 And that's a little game called chink-a-chink.